guest tonight is the founder of the World Science Festival. Please welcome my actual favorite theoretical physicist, Brian Greene. Well, we always love having you on to talk about science, because we love it. But the last time you were here, our government was slightly more science-friendly than it is now. Have you or your colleagues been affected in any way by this?
Yeah, it's utterly awful. I mean, for more than 50 years, science has driven innovation, prosperity. And look, if you want to make America great again, you make America smart, you make America think, and you keep America at the frontier of science.
Okay. One of the things we like having you on for is that often you're here when we're talking about an anniversary of a major breakthrough in modern science. What are we celebrating right now?
Well, this is the 90th anniversary of one of the most famous experiments in all of science. It's called the double-slit experiment, and it established the quantum laws of physics.
Okay, and the double-slit is that the baking soda volcano with two holes in the top? What is the double-slit?
It's an experiment which is pretty straightforward to describe. In fact, I have a few animations that can give you a feel for it.
Okay, so we'll take a look at this first one.
Yeah, so just imagine that you have a gun that's firing bullets or pellets at a screen that has two slits, two openings. Those are the double slits. And your intuition tells you that those pellets that get through the left opening will land in a band aligned with it on the left, and those that get through the right will land in a band aligned with it on the right.
That makes sense.
And that's what happens.
With bullets.
Just good, with bullets.
Okay.
Let's now run that experiment with one change. We're simply going to dial down the size of the bullets, making them smaller, as small as little particles like electrons. Your intuition tells you that pretty much the same thing should happen.
Right.
Those electrons that go through the left will land in a band on the left. Those that go through the right will land in a band on the right. But the amazing thing, which was discovered in 1927, is that that's not what happens. This was an experiment that actually happened in some sense by accident. There were two physicists out at Bell Labs, Davison and Germer. They're doing an experiment. It explodes. They fix it by the nickel crystal they were firing electrons on. It got tarnished. They heated it up. And when they heated it, they unwittingly changed the experiment into what we're going to look at right here. And what they found is when you fire the electrons at the barrier with the two slits, you don't just get two bands. You get more bands. And that simple change, going from our expectation of two bands to, in this case, five bands, that represents the single greatest upheaval in our understanding of reality that the species has ever encountered.
Why does that happen? Okay. Why does that happen?
That is the question. Why does this happen?
Yeah, that is my question.
And amazingly, we have the mathematics, the math of quantum physics, that describes that perfectly, right? But 90 years later, we are still arguing about what that math tells us about the nature of reality.
Because if those bullets get small enough, things get uncertain.
Things get uncertain, and moreover, because the bands are spread out, it must mean that the particles themselves, in some sense, are spread out, which leads us to the idea that particles are actually waves. If a wave goes
through... But particles at the same time.
That's right. So they're both particles and waves at the same time. That's the crazy thing.
Okay, that uncertainty at that small scale, how come I don't feel that uncertainty, you know, at the big scale? I'm here. I'm not particle and wave. I'm particle, aren't I?
You think so.
I do.
Yeah. The math shows quite clearly that the bigger you get, the weirdness of the quantum world gets suppressed.
Okay.
But it's still there. So you actually are subject to the laws of quantum physics.
Can we demonstrate some quantum weirdness at a scale that people would understand?
Yeah.
What is this over here? What are we demonstrating? Is this, are you?
Yeah, you want to check this out?
Quantum over
there?
Yeah, yeah. Let's take a look.
Yeah, this is called quantum levitation. And when we learned the quantum laws, we were able to understand a whole class of strange materials called superconductors, right? A superconductor is a piece of material. It's embedded in this plastic casing, which when you make it very cold, like 300 degrees below zero, it conducts electricity without any resistance. Now, to make it cold, we need some liquid nitrogen. So that's what we use over here. So I'm glad you've got your gloves on.
Yeah, we keep a tank of that around all the time.
Yeah, no, it's very good stuff here.
That goes in there.
That's right. So we can pour this in here. That's right. Mm-hmm. Don't really need the rest.
How long do we leave
get
that
rid
in there?
Of it over there.
Okay, that's. Right. I'm going to bill you for that.
Yeah, there you go. So here's the thing. Mm-hmm. So a superconductor detests magnetic fields.
Okay.
Which means if I bring it near a strong magnet, this is a very strong magnet right over here.
Do I pick this up?
Yeah, I'm going to pick it up and I'm going to let you manipulate it. So let me put this over here on the top. Watch what happens right there.
Whoa.
And in fact, if you hold it still, I can put it to a side. Look at that. Strange angle. It still holds in. And what's happening here is the superconductor is expelling magnetic fields, but quantum mechanics allows magnetic spikes, quantum spikes, to penetrate through the disk and grab hold of it. And in fact, let me hold it for 1 second, because I want you to feel it. Push straight down on that. What are you feeling?
Whoa, lot of resistance.
That's a lot of resistance. So you are actually putting this right into the quantum spike, so much so that you can turn this upside down like that. So it's not just two magnets repelling each other. It's actually quantum tentacles. And this is a circular magnet. I can put this on. Give this a little spin, a little gentle spin.
And is that how fidget spinners were invented?
Yeah. There you go.
What happens over here?
All right, so now let's take this guy over here.
Okay.
Now, this is a circular track, so the field is uniform along. So if I take,
Mr. Scientist, even I know not to put my fingers in liquid nitrogen.
Now, I want you to take this guy and give this guy a gentle little push. See that? Look at that. Now we can also.
How soon until I go to work on one of these things?
Oh, that's going to be a while. But check this out. We can even do this upside down. Now this doesn't always work, but let me give this a whirl over here. All right, here we go. Come up the other side here, and let's put this here. And I will do this barehanded. Anything for science. And there it goes. Look at that.
Wow.
So it's holding on to it.
Professor Brian Greene, everybody. Quantum levitation. We'll be right back.